नमस्ते, मैं त्रिवेणी खुराना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, फैकल्टी ऑफ फिजियोथेरेपी एंड डायग्नोस्टिक्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट स्पाइनल कॉर्ड इंजरी। व्हाट इज स्पाइनल कॉर्ड इंजरी? इट इज डैमेज टू द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड दैट रिजल्ट्स इन अ लॉस ऑफ फंक्शन सच एज मोबिलिटी और फीलिंग। देर आर टाइप्स ऑफ स्पाइनल कॉर्ड इंजरीज as complete spinal cord injury. In this, complete paraplegia is permanent loss of motor and nerve function at T1 level or below, resulting in loss of sensation, bladder and sexual region, a movement in the legs, arm and hands retain normal function. Other than this, we have Brown Sequard syndrome, posterior cord syndrome, central cord syndrome and anterior cord syndrome, which comprises incomplete spinal cord injury. Now, what are the various risk factors of spinal cord injury? Men are more prone, young adults and seniors, people who are active in sports, people with predisposing conditions. Now, what are the causes of spinal cord injury? These may consist of bullet and stab wound, traumatic injury, electric shock, extreme twisting of the middle of the body, landing on the head during sports injury, and fall from a great height. What is cervical neck injury? In this, there are characterized by breathing difficulties, loss of normal bowel and bladder control, numbness, sensory changes, and spasticity. Thoracic level or chest level injuries are characterized by loss of normal bowel and bladder control, numbness, sensory changes, spasticity, weakness, and paralysis. Lumbar sacral or lower back injuries are characterized by loss of normal bowel and bladder control, numbness, pain, sensory changes, weakness, and paralysis. Spinal cord injury may be confirmed by taking X-rays, by studying magnetic resonance imaging, and other scans. There are some complications associated with spinal cord injuries, such as blood pressure changes. It can be extreme, which is caused by autonomic hyperreflexia. Others are chronic kidney disease, contractures, and complications of immobility involved deep vein thrombosis, pulmonary infection, and skin breakdown. Other than these, loss of sensation, loss of bowel control, loss of bladder control, increased risk of urinary tract infection, loss of sexual functioning, muscle spasticity, paralysis of breathing muscle, paralysis, pressure shock can be seen. Now, how can we treat or rehabilitate spinal cord injury patients? By cognitive rehabilitation therapy, speech therapy, mental rehabilitation, physical exercises, and occupational therapy. Thank you.